Hey guys, it's Sarah, and I totally could have fixed my hair before I started this, but I know I've actually done this video before, but I was watching it last night because I'm so conceited that I love to watch my own video. I watched it last night and it was pretty bad. I figured I would re-record it in slightly better quality. I'm still pretty self-conscious about my tattoos. I love them for what they are for me, but I still get really nervous about people judging me for them because a lot of people have. Please be kind to everyone, not just me. I, in my usual fashion, did not get any sleep last night. I'm just gonna tell you this little anecdote so you know why I don't look my best. Not really, that's just an excuse. I never look my best. I don't even know if I have a best to look. Just kidding. A little. But last night, I was laying in bed reading Insomnia by Stephen King, and I was already a bit anxious because it was creeping me out. When I look down, and what do I see but a gigantic spider just casually crawling along my floor up to my bedside table. So naturally, I grabbed the cat who was still sleeping, flopped him over my shoulder, left the room, closed the door, and went and laid in the spare bed and then couldn't sleep because I just kept picturing this giant spider in the roof, like a woman in a spider suit though, just like sending out her little spider minions like, let's go freak this bitch out, it's so funny. And me just crying hysterically because I haven't slept in days because I know there's a spider in this house, but I don't know where it is now. Anyway, on to the tattoos, which is the point of this video. First tattoo that I ever got was the triangle on my wrist. I got it as a symbol of strength and also because religion-wise I affiliate myself most closely with Wicca, and the number 3 is a very powerful number, and triangles have 3 points. It's also the symbol for water and fire, femininity, masculinity, depending which direction it's facing. So all of that jazz in one little symbol on my wrist. That's why I got it. Not a hipster. I got it about almost a decade ago, about 8 years ago. Next tattoo that I am going to show you is a K that I have on my wrist. Boy, does this one come with a story. I was really good friends with this person. They were going through something where they really needed some support, or at least I hope that they were going through it. Not that I wanted them to go through it, but I just hope it wasn't a lie, because if it was, it was a horrible one. Solid friendship we had. But the memory of getting it is still one that I really love. We got them done together because I said I was getting his initials, so he's like, well, I'm gonna get yours. We got them done together in a guy's backyard and it cost us 20 bucks each. The dude did it freehand. It smelled very strongly of weed. The next tattoos that I am going to show you are the ones on my thighs. Not many people seem to know that I have these, probably because I wear pants a lot of the time, even though you guys know that I hate pants. Don't particularly want to go into the story for these ones, but they are, I'll say, because this is an issue that many people deal with in their lives, unfortunately, I will say that I got them as a reminder to myself that I still have my pride, I still have my dignity, and it's okay to say no. Also, stay tuned for the end of this video because there will be bloopers because I'm feeling very strange today and keep messing up this video. The next tattoo I'm going to show you is the one on my ribs, which is pretty literal. I was dealing with my nan's death and struggling with it, and I really just wanted to rip my heart out and give it away so I wouldn't have to feel anymore. The last tattoo that I'm going to show you is the one on the back of my neck. I also got it from my nan. Sorry that the angle is a bit skewed, I'm a little bit to the side. I got that one in the style that I got it in obviously. I got that one in that particular style because it was an illusion? Because it alluded to my love of fiction and writing and kind of dealing with that kind of thing through my writing, like dealing with loss and basically just general life stuff as well. Anyway, I'm gonna let you guys go. Remember, leave a comment below, or if you have a tattoo video or something, or Instagram or anything, feel free to spam your links below and be my friend and subscribe. Thank you guys so, so much for watching. I will see you next Tuesday and see you on Saturday with a book related video. Yep. I hope I'm not yelling at you. I feel really energetic today for some reason. Hopefully that comes across. A cloth? This tattoo I'm gonna show you. Hair on my face. Biggest mistake. You can... Yeah, that's my spider. It's okay, false alarm.